meeting me again. So today we are going to prepare the yasti kashaya, and I'm going to show you how the procedure is. And this kashaya we are using for the treatment of the seka. But before you are seeing all the procedure, if you are not yet subscribed my channel, please subscribe and give a like. And in here I already have 1 liter of the water, and I keep ready for 20 gram of the yasti churna. So what we have to do is, we just keep 1 liter of the water and 20 gram of churna, and we will mix. And we are planning to reducing for half, so the final product will be 500. In this procedure, we are using the total kashaya 500 ml, in which we are dividing into 250 ml for the right side and 250 ml for the left side. In each side, we are doing 6 times. And for the preparation of the kashaya, we are usually not use the full of the fire. We will be use mild one. Okay guys, before you already saw how we are boiling the kashaya, and in the beginning we are already prepared 1 liter, and now after boiling for around 30 minutes it's already in the 500 ml, and now we are going to filter because we are going to do seka, so we have to filter very nicely. And my friend is holding the gauze, so I'm going to show you the procedure of the Vidalaka today, but before that we are having the kawayantra here and guduchi. So you can see, this is, we have the guduchi patra. So what we have to do is just keep few.
Guduchi is one among the most highly referred herb of Ayurvedic medicine. One of the divining characteristic of the plant is its green heart shaped leaf. Pariseka is the procedure of the pouring the liquid medicine very slowly to open and close eye approximately in the highest is 4 angula length. There are so many certain medication which we can use according to the condition of the patient, so consultation to the concerned physician are required. And in this video we are performed by using the yasti madu. Yasti it is contain the flavonoid which act as an antioxidant. It also contains terpenoid, anti-inflammatory, and also act as on ciliary muscle, inhibiting the succession of the myopia. So how the mode of the action of the seka? When drugs are administered systematically, many of the drugs cannot cross the blood aqueous, blood vitreous, and blood retinal barrier. But with the seka, main barriers for the drug absorption directly over the eyes can be happen. This kashaya, which carries certain amount of the hydrophilic and lipidophilic action to provide the absorption through the cornea and conjunctiva. Separate kashaya should be used for the different eye to avoid the infection spreading, and the temperature should not be so much hot and should not be so cool also. Gentle massage can be provided to the eyes after seka to give the relaxation feeling for the eye. Okay, now I'm going to demonstrate the Vidalaka treatment. So what is the Vidalaka actually? It is the application of the medicated paste to the outer surface of the eyelids. The space should be restricted to the lids and not extended to the eyelashes. And when we can give this? For the indication of the Vidalaka, we can give when there is a burning sensation in the eye, excessive tears, swelling, redness, different type of the pain, if there is a itching, or if there is a foreign body sensation in the eyes. So when we should not do or we should not give or contraindication of the Vidalaka? We can't give for the person who are always excessive speaking, anger or grief or always weeping, because it may aggravate the Vata, or the person who are always wandering under the sun because it will be aggravate the Pitta, or for the person who are always have a day sleep because it will be aggravate the Kapha. So thank you so much for the watching.